Hello, friends. Welcome to another episode by Engineering Today. And we're back with three updates today. Let's discuss first how ULA is fighting back to regain the position they used to have in pre-SpaceX era. In August 2020, the U.S. Air Force awarded United Launch Alliance and SpaceX to carry out their launch missions for the next 5 years. Both Blue Origin and Northrop Grumman also participated for that contract. But lastly, the two companies did not get the taste of winning. Jeff Bezos' private aerospace company, Blue Origin, is currently on track with their New Glenn rocket, which they plan to debut in 2020. After the completion of their new space vehicle, the company will make their move on the commercial space industry. Although the company is now trying to convince the Air Force to continue the funding for the development of their New Glenn rocket. According to Blue Origin's Director of Government and Legislative Affairs, Megan Mitchell, we're discussing with the Air Force the path forward for certification. In October 2018, the Air Force awarded the $500 million Launch Service Agreement contract, which was initially spread over 6 years. Blue Origin won a Launch Services procurement contract that would have lasted for 2024. However, the Air Force previously announced that the companies who did not win a launch service contract could not have the LSA contract, which is applied for Blue Origin. On August 7, 2020, the Air Force planned to terminate the LSA's contract for Blue Origin and Northrop Grumman, as the agency did not have enough money to continue the funding, according to Will Roper, who is the Assistant Secretary of the Air Force for Acquisition. Although the company could not share any information about how much money from the $500 million LSA contract has been spent to develop their New Glenn and ground infrastructure, we had begun development of national security space unique infrastructure required to meet national security needs. We also completed the initial segment of the National Security Space Launch Certification process, the assessment phase, according to Mitchell. Mitchell also said the benefit of continuing the funding for the New Glenn rocket development, if it does not get terminated then, they would get a third certified launch provider, strengthening assured access to space for critical national security space assets. The Air Force decided to work only with ULA and SpaceX for the next 5 years, as they won the service launch contract. But it's not a bad idea to keep other service providers for backup. Blue Origin, as a third provider, could carry out launch missions for emergency purposes. Mitchell stated, "As space becomes increasingly contested, the national security space community needs more options at their disposal, not less. Our business case does not depend on national security. There's a robust civil and commercial market, but the national security community is an important long-term customer for Blue Origin," according to Mitchell. Blue Origin is trying to convince the Air Force that it would require easy and cheap modifications for the New Glenn rocket. "Adding these unique requirements later, when we're at full flight rate, will be much more costly," Mitchell said. Meanwhile, the company also built a huge rocket factory located outside the Kennedy Space Center in Florida to manufacture New Glenn boosters, and currently working on a launch pad at Cape Canaveral Air Force Station. In February 2020, Blue Origin opened a factory in Huntsville, Alabama to produce engines for New Glenn, also for United Launch Alliance's Vulcan rocket. Genius entrepreneur Elon Musk's company, SpaceX, is currently dominating the space market with its power-packed and reliable space vehicles. However, this has threatened other aerospace companies who are competing over launch contracts in this industry. United Launch Alliance is not an exception for this, as the company is concerned about competing with the industry's top player. On Tuesday, October 20th, during a third quarter earnings call with analysts, Lockheed Martin executives mentioned that ULA has been able to stay on track to compete with SpaceX. Lockheed Martin and American multinational company, Boeing jointly owned ULA, Ken Posenride, who's CFO, Chief Financial Officer of Lockheed Martin, stated that, "We now have a price point that's compelling to customers that will allow ULA to get its fair share of awards over SpaceX." ULA and SpaceX are rivals to each other, but both the companies hold a satisfying record for launch contracts. As per the contract, ULA will launch 60% of NSL missions, while the remaining 40% of the missions will be flown by SpaceX. What I would say is, of the recent competitions we've had with them, we've actually been pleased with the outcome of where ULA landed relative to SpaceX, Post and Ride stated. Going forward, we're confident. Post and Ride took side with ULA, as he said, "We've seen SpaceX as an emerging threat. They are more than an emerging threat now." During a call with analysts, Lockheed Martin CEO Jim Taislet said the company is pretty much confident about their space business. Lockheed Martin has an annual sale of $65 billion, where the company spent $12 billion for its space programs. Lockheed Martin's most of the profits come from traditional military satellite constellations, such as the Advanced Extremely High Frequency and the Global Positioning System, also the Space-Based Infrared System. According to Taislet, the company's real breakthrough was to win the Space Development Agency contract for 10 satellites. That mission will be part of a low Earth orbit constellation, which he said would be similar to what you're hearing about in the commercial sector, that will be able to transmit 5G speed, capacity, and latency signals between all domains. The Space Development Agency's Transport Layer Mesh Network is sort of one of the first elements of what we would envision in the future of a 5G mil architecture. Taislet added, "So yeah, it's an important piece. This will be a competitive space, but we want to get out in front of it." Now, in our last section, we'll cover a news regarding an agreement between the U.S. Army and Tricept Corporations. On Wednesday, October 21st, Tricept Corp went public to announce a launch services agreement with the U.S. Army's Space and Missile Defense Command, SMDC. As per the agreement, Tricept will play the role of launch broker and integration manager in this CubeSat technology demonstration mission, scheduled to launch on Rocket Lab's Electron rocket, Mahia, New Zealand, in 2021. According to the CEO of Tricept, Rob Spicer, Tricept is thrilled to have secured the rideshare slot, dispenser hardware, regulatory compliance in both nations, and spacecraft integration for this important technology demonstration in space. We look forward to integrating this small but game-changing payload aboard a Rocket Lab Electron in the coming months. The mission, also known as Gunsmoke J, is basically a joint capability technology demonstration project. According to the Launch Services Agreement, this project will be carried out by the U.S. Army Space and Missile Defense Command and sponsored by both the Office of the Undersecretary of Defense and the U.S. Army. Eddie Johnson, who is the program manager of Gunsmoke J project, stated, "This science and technology effort will demonstrate an entry-level capability in a 3U form factor relevant to U.S. Army warfighter needs. The mission will also help inform future acquisition decisions." As per the plan, Tricept will first integrate the CubeSat along with the dispenser 30 days before the launch date. It will be done in Rocket Lab's Long Beach facility in California. Secondly, company officials will visit the launch site in New Zealand just 2 or 3 weeks before the liftoff to manage the integration and encapsulation of the dispenser. In February 2021, the device will lift off on top of Electron's upper stage. Tricept has had a good relationship with both Rocket Lab and Space and Missile Defense Command, which can prove to be an advantage in their mission. The relationship between Tricept and SMDC was created during a mission where Tricept was the mission integrator for the U.S. Air Force in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Tricept also integrated several CubeSats, which were launched in 2018 on Rocket Lab's Electron rocket. It was NASA's 19th educational launch of NanoSatellite's mission. Moreover, Tricept still has a launch services agreement with Rocket Lab and two other companies to integrate Drag Racer. This mission will be carried out on Rocket Lab's upcoming Electron flight. According to Jason Armstrong, who's the Launch Integration Services Director of Tricept, through that relationship, we've been able to establish a process for identifying launch opportunities for a number of different payloads SMDC is continuing to develop. SMDC rideshare exemplifies the very heart of our overall vision at Rocket Lab, that even the smallest of these small satellites can make a major difference in both commercial and government markets. According to Lars Hoffman, Senior Vice President of Rocket Lab's Global Launch Services. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.